Meanwhile, the candidates vying to fill the state Senate seat vacated by Manchester's Mayor Ted Gatsas, hoping that the weather doesn't keep people away from the polls tomorrow. The special election for District 16 is tomorrow. The district covers Hooksett, Candia, Bow, Dunbarton, along with wards 1 and 2 and 12 in Manchester. Now, both candidates are pushing job creation as their campaigns push people to get out and vote.
If you live in the area, you probably already know this. The Senate seat sign war has been on for a while in Greater Manchester.
David Booten, running for the state Senate.
And now, so is the last-minute push to get voters to the polls.
What are you hearing from the people on the street?
I'm hearing that people are two things. One, they're tightening their belts. Why isn't the state? And number two, they're incensed about this new job-killing small business income tax.
We're hearing a lot of things from people. I mean, the biggest thing is jobs and the economy. People want to get back to work. And I'm looking forward to working with Governor Lynch and his New Hampshire Working Program that he unveiled in the state of the state.
While Democratic candidate and firefighter Jeff Goley was on a 24-hour shift at a Manchester firehouse, his supporters could be found working the phones on this day before the election. Meanwhile, he and Republican David Booten are facing off to fill the Senate seat vacated by now Mayor Ted Gatsas.
And since this is a special election with only one race in the ballot, it's fair to say that voter turnout could be less than impressive. And with the storm in the forecast, a vote here or a vote there could make the difference.
To beat the winter storm, both campaigns are also offering rides to the polls. And in the end, they both know this election may serve as a referendum of sorts to those who are simply struggling to get by.
Absolutely. The economy, you know, we're low income right now, just making it. So we're doing everything we can.
All right, so the polls open tomorrow as early as 6 a.m. And for a complete list of poll times and locations, you can go to the politics section of our website at WMUR.com.